All right, you guys, welcome to class. I don't know what the deal is, but it's going really, really slow. I think I'm going to have to refresh or something.
Hello.
All right, can you guys hear and see me okay now?
Yes, okay.
Okay, before, yeah, it was crazy. Everything was frozen. Well, good to have you guys here. Selene, how are you? Where are you from?
Hello. Hi, Italy.
From Rome. Italy? Great.
Yeah.
From Rome, okay.
Hello.
Hi. Cool. Let's see, Oscar. How you doing, Oscar? Welcome back.
Thanks. I'm fine. I'm from Spain.
From Spain. Very cool, man. Well, good to have you guys here. Let's see. We also have, let's see, Zaki. How you doing, Zaki? Welcome back.
I'm doing great. Thank you. I'm doing great. What about you?
I'm doing very well. Thank you. All right. We also have, let's see, Amparo's back in. Hi there, Amparo. Let's wait for your microphone to, there we go.
The hangout party is over, then crashing, frosting, I don't know.
Yeah, mine, as I was coming in, it crashed on me. I was like, no, why?
Why again?
I don't know. Let's see here. Christian, how you doing, Christian? Christian, unmute your microphone. I can't hear
you. Okay, can you hear me now?
Yes, I can. How you doing?
Hello, how you doing?
I'm doing great. Christian, where are you from?
Chile. I'm from Chile.
From Chile. Okay, cool. And does it, let's see, do you work in financials?
No.
Computing. Okay, I was just looking at your whiteboard there. Very good. Well, good.
Oh, yeah, that was a partner writing about the offering of our firm, and they're discussing what products we can offer to our customers.
Oh, okay, yeah, that's why I looked at it. I was like, huh, that looks like financials. Let's see. All right, cool, man. Good to have you here. Let's see. Sim, how you doing, Sim? Okay. How about Action? Hi there, Action. Welcome to class.
Hello.
Thank you, Chad.
Hello.
Very good. Is that Sim? Hi, Sim.
Hello. How are you?
I'm doing good. Sim, where are you from?
Basically, I'm from India, but I have been living in London 3 years ago.
Okay, so you've been living in London for 3 years.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Very good. Well, it's good to have you here.
Thank you.
All right, very good. Now, is anyone currently at this time preparing for TOEFL?
Well, I'm preparing for IELTS right now.
Okay, you said IELTS, okay?
Yes.
All right, okay. All right, well, let me go over a little bit about TOEFL and how this practice works. So we're going over parts 1 and 2. Right? This is when you have 15 seconds to think of an answer. Okay, and then 45 seconds to then answer the question. Okay, and these are all types of questions that deal with a whole range of topics. Okay, now when you answer the question, you need to answer it in a specific form. Okay, you need to have an introduction, okay, supporting statements, and then a conclusion. All right, when you do that, it's sort of like writing a mini essay. right? You only have 45 seconds, so you need to get through your intro really quick and your conclusion very quick, all right? Now, these are good practices for TOEFL, or not only for TOEFL, but this style of answering questions is great for interviews. Okay, I'm dealing with one of my Japanese students right now. He is the CFO of a major company, and he's looking to go to Australia, and he's in the third step of his interview process, and this is the type of questions that he gets, okay? And these are the answers that he's giving in this format, and he's flying through the interview. So this process works, okay? If you can show that you can answer questions intelligently and quickly, all right, you will move further ahead, not only in business, in schooling, okay, getting interviews and going to different schools, okay, but also in life, okay? Good. So let's take a look here. There is a link I'm going to share with you guys that has the questions. I'm going to put the questions in the Google chat box, all right? I won't be in the Verbling chat box, you guys, but the Google chat box. The Google chat box is the blue one at the very top of your applications, okay, on the left-hand side, right? So, hi there, Donato, how you doing?
I'm fine, chat.
Excellent.
Very happy to see you. And
good to see you as well.
Hi, everybody.
Awesome. John, how you doing, John?
Hi, teacher.
Hi there. Good to have you here.
Thank you.
All right, very cool, you guys. Okay, so let's go ahead and get rolling. Get to my clock as well. Okay, when we go through these, you guys, after you give your answer, okay, I'll be looking at your structure, your pronunciation, at your grammar, okay, and how well you answer the question. Right. So we are on page number one, and we're going to start off over on the left-hand side with action. Okay, and I believe. Okay, yep, we are on number four, mm-hmm. I think.
Yeah, that was the last one.
Yeah, that was the our next one, right? So, okay, action number four. Go ahead and read this, please.
Some people believe that a college or university education should be available to all students. Others believe that higher education should be available only to good students. Discuss these views. Which view do you agree with? Explain why.
Okay. You have 15 seconds to prepare. Okay, ready?
Okay.
Go ahead.
I believe that higher education should be available only to good students. Firstly, because in the middle school, all students are not equal, so they have some of them are really good at education and the science, so. And for the society, and secondly, for society, we need the people who will do the handworks, and so some of them will cook, some of them will work in the construction, and if we take all of them to the higher education, it will not good for the society. And above all, I think that yes. To be equal to all of the students is good, but in the education, some people are really good because they have ability to think, to read, to study well, and some of them are not. So we should.
Okay, let me pause you there.
Yeah, okay,
so we're over by 30 seconds. Okay. So after you said your last point, when you were talking about the society, that's when you needed to end. You had about 5 seconds left, and you could have gone into your conclusion. Okay, and you would have been okay. So you really only need about 2, maybe 3 points, supporting sentences there. Okay. Now your pronunciation was pretty good. Okay, I understood your words fairly well. Okay. Now one grammar point I want to talk about is in the last one your second point you said, if we take all of them to the higher education, it will not be good. Okay. Instead of saying if we take all of them to the higher education, it would be best to say if all of them got higher education, or if all of them received higher education, it wouldn't be good. Instead of will not, wouldn't, because we're talking about a hypothetical. Okay. So we're looking at our conditional sentences. Okay. Now your first reason, I didn't quite understand that much. Can you explain your first reason to me? You were talking about in the high school and something like that. Can you explain what that was?
Maybe I was talking about that. We should take all of the students to the middle school, but not the universities. My point was that, but I don't know. I think I could not explain it very well.
Okay, so you're saying that everybody should get at least a middle school or high school education, but not everybody needs to go to college because some
that's right.
Going to be okay. I see what you're saying. All right, so in that case, let's see. Okay, so it wouldn't be that everybody that we should take them to middle school or that they should have that type of education, but that not everybody wants to wants to have a job that requires education like that. That might be the best way to put that. Okay, now your introduction was really good. Okay, you stated your point right off the bat. Now do the same thing in your conclusion. Okay, and you said, in my opinion, I don't believe everyone should receive a higher education. Okay, in your conclusion, those are the reasons why I don't believe everybody should receive higher education.
Yeah, that's okay.
Okay, that's your conclusion. Okay. All right, nice job, Action. Much better with your introduction. I like that. Much better this time. Very good. Okay, let's go to Amparo. Amparo number 5, please.
Oops. Some people say that physical exercise should be a required part of every school day. Other people believe that students should spend the whole school day on academic studies. Which opinion do you agree with? Use specific reasons and details to support your answer.
Okay, 15 seconds. Ready? Oops. Dang it. I pressed the wrong button. I'll go up over a minute here, okay?
Okay.
Okay, go ahead.
I agree that physical exercise should be a required part of every school day because the students are sitting in the class most of the time, and then when they go back home, they stay there hours in front of the TV or in front of the computer, so they need to have more activities, physical activities. Nowadays, the diet that in many cases are not more healthy, and that is contributing to increase the obesity rate. The health problems. So that is why I think the physical exercise should be required in every school.
Okay, good. Yeah, so you were just about there on with time. Okay, wasn't too bad at all. Okay, very nice. I liked your introduction. You had supporting statements. Okay, and your conclusion. Okay, your structure was really nice. Okay, I want to take a look at some grammar here.
Okay.
Okay. The first one. Mm-hmm. You said they stay their hours in front of the TV, okay, and computer. How can we correct that?
They stayed in front of TV and computer for hours.
Okay. Yeah, they stay or they sit. Okay. They sit. I wouldn't say stay because stay has a meaning of when I go and visit Ecuador, finally I'll call you up and say, hey, we're here. Do you have a place for us to stay? And you say, yeah, come over to our place. You can stay with my family. Okay, mm-hmm. That's what stay means, to kind of rest someplace. Mm-hmm. Okay, so I wouldn't say stay their hours. Okay, probably they sit in front of the TV, or they spend. You can also say spend. Mm-hmm. They spend many hours sitting in front of the TV or computer.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. The other one here is, okay, the diet are not more healthy. Okay, we're talking about the food. The diet are not more healthy. How can we correct this?
The diet are.
The diet
the
are.
It is not. It's not. Because the diet, in many cases, mm-hmm. is not the more healthy.
Okay, do we say not the more healthy? How many syllables does healthy have, and what does it end
yeah,
with?
Yeah, the healthier.
Okay, is not healthier. Okay, we could say mm-hmm. than before. Yes. Mm-hmm. Okay, mm-hmm. So the diet is not healthier than before.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Or we can actually change that to their diet is not healthier than before. Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. Good. Good. Nice job, Amparo. Okay, and again, good job with your structure. I didn't hear any words that were really mispronounced either. Okay, really nice. Okay, let's go to Christian.
Yep.
All right, Christian, number 6.
Okay. If you could make one important change in a school that you attend, what change would you make? Use reasons and specific examples to support your answer.
Okay. 15 seconds to prepare. Okay, ready?
Okay.
Go ahead.
Yeah. One important change I could make on a school is to improve their physical exercise, because for one thing it accelerates the metabolism, so the people is more awake when they are in class, and you can improve your physical health through that exercise. And another change I could make would be for classes to be more interactive, because one person can learn more interacting with other people and exchanging opinions than just reading or copying a text from the blackboard. I think that would be the main change or the most important change I would make in classes in school.
Okay. All right. Okay, good. Now, your structure was pretty good. Okay. The one thing that I want to add there is an introduction, and your introduction can be, you know, really, really brief, okay? Because you basically started it off with your main point, okay? So, for example, this is what I mean. Okay, so we want to go right to the question. If you could make one important change in a school that you attended, what change would you make? Okay, so you're sort of going to repeat that question and answer it at the same time. Okay, an important change that I would make in a school that I attended would be, or some important changes that I would make in a school that I have attended is, okay, and then you would go in, and then you would go into your answers there, okay? Or you could say, if I could make one important change to a school that I attended, I would.
Okay.
And then go into it from there. Right? I want to go to, all right, a change I would make on a school. This is going to be grammar, okay? So instead of saying a change I would make on a school, how could we correct that? a change I would make on a school.
In?
Okay, the change I would make in a school. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, and you could also say a change that I would make. In would probably be best. Okay. Next one here. The people are more awake in class. All right, so since we are talking about school, okay, instead of saying the people, I would probably say the students.
Okay.
Okay, so that the students are more awake during class, right, instead of just saying the people. Okay.
Okay.
Now, pronunciation-wise, I want to work on the word interactive.
Interactive?
There you go. That's much better. Okay. When you're focusing on it, you pronounce it very well. Before you said interactive. Okay. Using a hard R, so it's interactive. Try that one more time. Interactive.
Interactive.
Great. Nice pronunciation. Okay. Now, with your conclusion. Okay. If you had an introduction, your conclusion would be pretty similar.
Okay. Okay.
So at the very end, you would say, so that is the change, or if you had more than one change, those are the changes I would make in a school that I attended.
Perfect.
Okay, and it wraps it right up. Okay? All right, very nice job, Christian. Very good.
Thank you.
Okay, let's go to Donato.
Okay, John.
All right, Donato, let's have you do number 7, please.
Okay, some people believe that students should be given one long vacation each year. Others believe that students should have several short vacations throughout the year. Which viewpoint do you agree with? Use specific reasons and examples to support your choice.
Okay. 15 seconds to prepare. Okay, ready?
Okay.
Go ahead.
I personally believe that students should be given a long vacation each year. Firstly, because that would allow them to, or the school to organize a long trip abroad and make an important and unforgettable experience. Secondly, because several short vacations would make them lose concentration during their studies. To sum up, that's why I believe that students should be given once a year-long vacation.
Oh, there we go. I don't know why. Every time I touch it, something goes wrong. Okay, nice job, Donato. Okay, you incorporated all of the things that we've been talking about. Simplifying your words, okay? Not getting too complicated, okay? Watching your time. Okay, using a good conclusion, using a good introduction. Okay, clearly stating what you were intending or what the answer is. Okay, this one was really, really good. Okay, all right, let's take a look at pronunciation. Okay, three words here. Okay, so first up is a long trip. Make sure, now trip was fabulous. Okay, trip was really good. Your TR was really good. Let's practice the L sound, a long trip. It sounded like you said long trip. Okay, a long trip abroad. Try that.
A long trip abroad.
There you go. Good. Let's practice the word experience. Okay, give me a good R here. Experience.
Experience.
Okay, force that tongue down instead of expedi. Experience. There you go. That's it. Good R sound. Next one. Okay, R as well. Instead of during, it's during.
During.
Great. All right. Again, nice job, Donato. Very good improvements from when you started. Awesome job. Okay.
Thanks.
Ended on time and everything. Really cool.
And thanks to my
master.
Yeah,
no problem. Nice. No way. You're the one that's doing the hard work, man. All right. Very good. Cool. Let's go to Stelene, right? She's my next Italian. Two Italians right in a row. All right, Stelene, you are
I'm
up
here.
Next.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, go ahead and read number 8, please.
Yes. Your school has received... Oh, sorry, let me read. Okay. Number 8. Your school has received a gift of money. What do you think is the best way for your school to spend this money? Use specific reasons and details to support your choice.
Okay.
Okay.
15 seconds to prepare.
Okay.
Okay, ready?
Yes, okay.
Go ahead.
I would use this money to buy computers because I think that they may be useful for researches, but also they can be used to download books and teaching materials that can be used by students for free. And this is the most important thing, because here in Italy we don't have a lot of this kind of electronic material like computers, but they are very important, and I would use the money by doing this for this.
Okay. Hold on 1 second. Okay. All right. Thank you very much, Selene. Nice job. Nice work. Okay. So what I first want to work on is the introduction.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You always want to start off with a brief introduction. You started right into it and said, this is what I would use the money for. Okay. Well, what you want to do, okay, is go right to your question. Your main question here is, what do you think is the best way for your school to spend this money? Okay. Mm-hmm. So grab right from that, and you're going to say, I believe so, or you can say, in my opinion, this is an opinion question. In my opinion, mm-hmm. the best way for my school to spend this money would be, okay, or is, and then you go into it from there. Okay, so you want to reference the question that you had just been asked.
Okay.
You could also turn this into a conditional. Okay, saying, if my school had received a gift of money, now that makes things a little more complicated, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then your whole answer would then be in second conditional, okay? But an easy way to do that, it would just be, in my opinion, okay, the best way to spend this money would be, okay, answering it
okay.
like that, okay? Now,
okay.
your reasons were pretty good, okay? I want to go to... the first word, researches. Okay, you said it was
mm-hmm.
useful for researches. Instead of saying useful for researches, it'd be useful for research.
Research, okay.
Okay, so yeah, we would not need to pluralize that. Okay, useful for research, because we're using that as a verb. Okay. Another one is a lot of this kind of electronic material. Let's practice the TH sound instead of a lot of this kind. We want to say
this kind.
That's it.
There you go.
Kind. Yeah, tongue between the teeth. One more time. A lot of this kind. There you go.
This kind. This.
There. That's it. Okay. So yeah, you don't want to fall into the trap of pronouncing the TH like this. Okay. Tongue between the teeth.
This.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, and yes, the last part you said, I would use the money for this, okay? And that was your conclusion, all right? Now, a good conclusion is going to sum up everything, okay? So after you state the fact that Italy doesn't have a lot of these electronic materials, okay,
mm-hmm.
or electronic devices, okay, then I would say, These are the reasons why I would spend my money on computers.
Okay, perfect. Thank you.
Okay. Yeah, so nice and easy. These are the reasons. You can also, like Donato said, so to sum up, okay, when you say sum up, that triggers to the listener, she's going to end. Or if you say in conclusion, okay, or therefore, okay, or all in all, okay, those words are obvious that you are going to be concluding, and you need to be very obvious that you are.
Okay.
Okay. And the easiest is so. So these are the reasons. So. Okay. All right. Nice job, Selene. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. Let's go to Sim. All right, Sim, are you there? Sim. Okay. Let's go to Zaki.
Okay.
Okay, Zaki, number 9, please.
Your school has enough money to purchase either computer for student or books for the library. Which should your school choose to buy, computers or books? Use specific reason and example to support your recommendation.
Okay. All right. So, Zaki, I need for you to take a breath. Okay, so take a breath before you're answering. Okay, relax yourself. You want to relax yourself so you're not speaking really quickly. Okay, when you're doing that, that's when you lose pronunciation. Okay, so relax a little bit, take a few breaths. Okay, and then I'm gonna give you 15 seconds to so you can think about it. Focus on your R sounds. Okay, you're going to be moving through this nice and smooth, nice and smooth. Don't rush yourself, okay? Focus on one, maybe 2 points, okay?
Okay,
just relax, right? And that hopefully this helps you out with your pronunciation of it, okay? So 15 seconds to prepare. Okay, ready?
Okay, ready.
Go ahead.
In my opinion, I would like to recommend the college, the school should purchase computers because the students can search everything through internet from the computers. Because nowadays you can find everything on internet. And my second reason is the students can. Students can know the computer, how to operate this, and how to get the information from the internet. So in this way, I would like those are the reasons I would like to recommend to the schools to purchase computers compared to book, rather than books.
Okay. All right. Okay. All right, better. Your structure is getting very, very nice, okay? You had your introduction, you had a couple of points, and a conclusion, okay? All right, so let's practice some of the phrases that you said, and we're going to work on pronunciation just a little bit, okay? All right, so first up, okay, is you can find everything. Okay, now here we do want to use the article. You left out the article for the. You can find everything on the internet. Okay, so let's try this. Okay, you can find everything on the internet. Nice and slow.
You can find everything on the internet.
Good, that's how you want to say it. Okay, one more time. You can find everything on the internet.
You can find everything on the internet.
Okay, let's try everything one more time. You can find, just everything. Everything.
Everything.
Okay, better. Now, if you slow down just a bit, okay, you become easier to understand. Okay. Okay, all right, let's try one more phrase here. Okay. How to get the information from the internet. This is another phrase that you said. Okay, how to get the information from the internet. Try that nice and relaxed, nice and slow.
How to get the information from the internet.
Yes, okay. All of your R's, you did not hit your tongue to the top of your mouth on any of those R's. okay? But when you're really going and you're nervous, okay, you tend to say information from the internet, okay? So you need to relax, control your tongue, okay? Let's try that sentence one more time. How to get the information from the internet?
How to get the information from the internet?
Yes, good. Okay, that's what we want. Okay, nice and smooth. Okay, I know you can do it. We're going to keep working on it. Okay, Zaki?
Okay.
Okay, we're getting there. We're getting there. Okay, nice job, man. Okay, let's go. Let's see. No. Sim, are you there?
Can you hear me?
Hi, Sim. I can hear you now. Yes. Okay, Sim. Let me have you take a look at number 10, please.
Okay. When a student move to a new school, they sometimes face problems. How can schools help these students with their problems? Use specific reason and examples to explain your answer.
Okay. You have 15 seconds to prepare.
Okay.
Okay, ready?
Okay. First, school management have to make sure was the students are feeling comfortable or not. If students are not feeling comfortable, they should speak with students individually because they did not feel hesitate. And wants to know what's the problem. They are why people are feeling uncomfortable, and then they have to deal the situation and solve the problem.
Okay. Well, let's pause. Let's pause there. Okay. Give me 1 second. Okay, so we were over time, and it didn't seem like you were going to get to your conclusion. Okay, so we're about 16 seconds over time here. Okay, so remember we have 45 seconds to answer this question. Right, it does seem like a short amount of time, but it definitely can be done. Right, so let's go to our question. We're gonna look. We're gonna go through, and we're gonna do intro. Supporting statements and a conclusion here, okay? So our main question is, how can schools help these students with their problems? Okay, this is going to be an opinion question. Okay, in my opinion, I believe these schools can help their students by, okay? Or, in my opinion, I believe these students can help, or sorry, these schools can help these students in two important ways, okay? And then you're going to give me those ways. Okay, so that's how you want to formulate an introduction here. Okay, then you go into it. Okay, now I had a hard time at times hearing exactly what you were saying, because I know you've got a beautiful child there. Okay, that was crying a little bit in the background, so I couldn't hear everything.
Yeah.
Right, but yeah. I did hear some things. Okay, so I want to practice the pronunciation of the word comfortable instead of comfortable.
It's comfortable.
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 All right, let me write. Yes, that's what it is. Comfortable.
Comfortable. Comfortable.
There you go. That's it. Comfortable. Okay.
All
right. The next. That's it. Comfortable. Okay. Now, the next one here, you said they have to deal this situation. Okay. When we deal with. Okay. Yeah. So typically, after the word deal, we have the word with. Okay? Deal with this situation. So then they have to deal with the situation. Try that sentence.
Okay.
All right, good. Yeah. Pay attention to those certain words. Comfortable, that's a key one. We do not pronounce it how it is spelled. Okay? It's not comfortable, it's comfortable. Okay? Then with the verb deal, we usually use the word with right after. Okay? All right. Thank you very much. Okay? Let's go to action. All right. Yeah, yeah. Action number 11, please.
Okay. You have been told that dormitory rooms at your university must be shared by 2 students. Do you rather have the university assign a student to share a room with you, or would you rather choose your own roommate? Use specific reasons and details to explain your answer.
Okay. All right, 15 seconds to prepare. Okay, remember, watch your time. Okay, we have 45 seconds. Once it from 15 seconds, it goes up to 1 minute.
Yeah.
All right, so watch that time. Once it gets to about 50 to 55 seconds, you need to start concluding, okay?
Yeah.
All right, 15 seconds to prepare. Okay, ready?
Yeah, okay. I would choose my own roommate because as a person who lived and studied abroad and always shared dormitory rooms and some houses with other persons, I absolutely would choose my own roommate because when it's really difficult to live with the people who you don't understand very well, and your character and don't match with the others. So because of these reasons, I totally would choose my own roommate.
Okay, good. Give me 1 second. Okay. All right. Nice job, Akron. We watched the time, okay, making sure that we were ending on time. Okay? You had a good conclusion at the very end, okay? The one thing we were lacking, though, is the intro at the very beginning. Okay? So at the very beginning, you came out and you said, I would choose my own roommate.
Yeah. Okay?
So we do want to say that, but we want to include some of this question here. Okay, would you rather have the university assign a student to share a room with you, or would you rather choose your own roommate? Okay. Now, let's see. If I was living at the university, okay, I would prefer to choose my own roommate. Okay? That would be the best way to introduce your answer. Okay? If I was living at a university or at the university, okay, I would prefer to choose my own roommate. Okay, for a couple of important reasons. Okay, or for a couple reasons, and then you go into those reasons. Okay, your reasons were actually good. I agree with both of them. Okay, or with all of them. For the same reasons, I would rather choose my own roommate as well. Okay, now right. I want to go to the pronunciation of the word lived. Okay, instead of saying livid, it's lived.
Lived.
Uh-huh, good. Yeah, so we skip right over that E sound, and it goes right to the D, lived, okay? Next word, next sentence is, share houses with other persons. Okay, I shared houses with other persons. Instead of persons, we say people.
Yep.
Okay. And you can probably say share different houses. I don't know. I've shared maybe many or different. I would probably add one of those two words in front. many or different in front of houses. Okay, I've shared many or different houses with other people. Okay. And the last one here is, and your character don't match with the other. Okay, and that would be, and your character doesn't.
Yeah.
Doesn't match. Okay.
Okay.
All right. So again, good job with the timing. Okay. Good conclusion this time. Just a little bit more work on that introduction. You were halfway there. You answered the question, but we need a little bit more setup for that question. Does that make sense?
Yeah. Okay.
All right. Cool, man. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yep. Let's go to Amparo. Okay, Amparo, number 12, please.
Okay. Do you agree or disagree with the following statement? High school should allow students to study the courses that students want to study. Use specific reasons and examples to support your opinion.
Okay. 15 seconds to prepare.
Okay.
Okay, ready?
Okay.
Go ahead.
I disagree that high schools should allow the students to study the courses they want. Teenagers are not mature enough to take a good decision, and probably after they had already taken a decision, they would like to change it. I think it is having a general knowledge in different subjects would allow you to have a wide group of choices at the moment when you are going to start the university. So that is because of the reasons I disagree with the, that students should just study the courses that they want.
Okay, good, good. All right, and yeah, you're pretty much there with time. Okay, over by just a bit. Okay, not too bad though. Okay, good introduction. You had your supporting statements. Okay, and your conclusion. Okay, stumbled a little bit on it, but only because it's the reverse, right? So you come back to it and you're like, oh no. Okay, so I would probably say, let's see. High school Shula. For these reasons, I disagree. So those are the reasons why I disagree that student. Yeah. So it's just a long sentence to kind of get through there at the very end. Okay. Yeah. Kind of trying to mush it in. Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. Now, one thing here. Okay. We make decisions instead of take.
Oh. Okay.
Okay, so we make good decisions. Okay, next one here. Now, this is at the very beginning. You said study the courses that they want to, and it sounded like you wanted to say two at the end. Did you say two there?
No.
Okay. Now you could have put two there. Study the courses that they want to. Okay, or study the courses that they want. Okay. Both either one is okay.
Okay. No, I didn't say that.
It may have just been a hard T sound at the very end. Want. Okay. Yeah, that's probably what it was then. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Either way, it was just fine. But and that's all I was gonna say. You could say two. You don't have to.
Okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. Good. Yeah. Everything else is pretty good. Okay. Okay. Nice job, Amparo. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, let's go to Christian. I believe Christian's next, right? Yeah, Christian's up next. All right, Christian, number 13.
Okay.
Okay, go ahead, please.
Some high schools require all students to wear school uniforms. Other high schools permit students to decide what to wear to school. Which of these two school policies do you think is better? Use specific reasons and examples to support your opinion.
Okay. Okay. All right, so we're looking for introduction, supporting statements, and a conclusion, right? Okay, so 15 seconds to prepare, Christian. Okay, ready?
Okay.
Go ahead.
Okay. In my opinion, about the school uniforms, I think that the best option would be that they wear a uniform, because that way you can set all the students on the same level. I mean, regarding their how would I say that? Without regarding to their wealth, but just that they are two people in the same course, and they can be friends, or they can study together, avoiding some classism or other issues about that. And that would be my opinion.
Okay, give me 1 second here. Okay, all right. So let's take a look here. So we had some concepts that kind of tripped you up just a little bit. Okay, let's talk about them. Okay, so you said without regarding to their wealth. Okay, all right, without regard for their wealth.
Okay.
Okay, without regard for their wealth. Okay, or you could also say. They would wear the uniform, and it doesn't. That's a lot of words. Yeah, without regard for their wealth, that's probably the best way to say that. Any other way, it's going to take maybe a sentence to get there. Because what I was thinking is, it doesn't. So when they wear the uniform, it doesn't matter whether they're rich or poor. Okay, yeah. No one's looking at their clothing, you know. That's the exact same reason why I support uniforms. Okay, next one, avoiding classism. Okay, so this way they would avoid classism. You could say classism, or the difference in the classes, okay, or between the classes. Classism works okay, though, okay?
Okay.
Now, at the very beginning here, you said, in my opinion, about the school uniforms, okay? So you're very close. You do want to start off with, in my opinion, okay? But you'd say, let's see, in my opinion, I believe schools, okay, should require students to wear school uniforms.
Okay.
So there isn't any need to clarify, okay? You just roll right into it. In my opinion, I believe schools should require all students to wear uniforms.
Okay.
Okay, and it's then you go right into your answer. Okay. But there was a couple of things there that kind of threw you for a loop. I could tell that you had in your mind what steps you were trying to take and trying to get there. But every once in a while, you get a question, and you're like, "What? No."
Yeah. Right?
So yeah, no.
I was trying to put some order in my mind, but sometimes it gets scrambled down.
Yeah.
I got nervous.
I agree. Your pronunciation was pretty good this time, though. Okay? I didn't hear anything that really jumped out and slapped me in the face. Okay? It was really good. Okay?
Okay, thanks.
Nice job. Let's go to Selene.
Yes.
All right, Selene, number 14, please.
Number 14, okay. In some countries, teenagers have jobs while they are still students. Do you think this is a good idea? Support your opinion by using specific reasons and details.
Okay, all right, so introduction, supporting statements, and a conclusion, okay?
Okay.
All right, so 15 seconds to prepare. Okay, ready?
Okay, yes.
Go ahead.
Okay, I really think that having a job while studying is a good idea for teenagers, because when I was a teenager, I used to have a job, and it really gave me an idea of what real life is, and real life is different from the life of a student. And being aware of other kind of responsibilities made me become more mature So this is the reason why I really agree with this idea of having a job while still a student.
All right. That was pretty good. Okay. Only two things here. Okay. At the very end. Okay. In your conclusion. So these are reasons why I believe it's a good idea for students to have a job, and then we would say while studying.
While studying. Oh yeah. Uh-huh. I knew that there was something wrong, but
yeah, just a little bit. Just a little bit. You were really, really good. Okay. It was really good. Okay. So yeah, you could say while studying, okay, or during school.
Okay.
So either of those two would work just fine, okay?
During school, okay.
Okay, now the only other word here is teenager, okay? So you want to put the stress at the very beginning instead of saying teenager. It's teenager.
Teenager, okay.
Okay, just like that, okay? Now, your introduction was solid. Okay, you had two reasons in there, okay? And you guys, that's another way of doing that, okay? She mentioned the two reasons, but you don't have to, and I know, Amparo, you do this every once in a while, where you don't really kind of mention, well, my first reason is this, my second reason is that, okay? You don't necessarily have to do that. Sometimes it just helps you as a speaker to organize your thoughts and to organize your answer, okay? But yeah, you don't have to. She didn't do that in this instance, and that's okay. Okay? She talked about gaining experience, okay, and real-world experience, real-life experience, okay, and then helping her mature, okay? So having a job, okay, that's why it's good, real-world experience and maturing, okay? Great answer. It was really, really nice, really solid, okay, and also under time. Okay, so that was good. Okay, very good, you guys. Well, thank you very much for coming into class. I apologize, Saki and Sim, I couldn't get around to you guys. The next time I do TOEFL, I'll start on the other side of the room. So, Saki, if you come into class, your name starts with a Z, so you're going to be first. Okay, so you'll probably be able to go twice. Okay, so excellent job, you guys. Really good job on taking my suggestions and incorporating them into your answers. Okay, really good. All right, you guys. I'm gonna take a break for a couple hours and be back for some afternoon classes. Okay, we'll see ya.
Thank you.
Take care. Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Thank you. Bye. Bye.
Bye.